Good morning. Now, this is unit 5, radar systems, from the paper communication system. So you have a paper named communication systems. So in that, I'll be taking you only unit 5, which is about radar systems. Okay. Now, there is a reference text. It is mentioned here, Introduction to Radar Systems by Merrill L. Skolnick. Second edition, actually, this is a test book that has got only a few topics from your syllabus, but all the topics are not covered in this book. So some topics are there, so that I have taken. So I am mentioning those topics that is discussed in this book here, and the rest I will give you notes. Okay, so now one thing that I would like to tell you is that this is just a theory paper. There is not much derivations and all. So it is just pure theoretical concept. So some topics I will give you class, whereas on some topics I will just upload the notes only. Okay, so you can just read and learn. Now you all know what a radar is. Radar means radio detection and ranging. So from the name itself, you know it's a device used not only for detection but also for ranging. That is, it is used to detect a distant object. At the same time, using the radar, you can also measure how much distance or how far that distant object is away from you. Okay, so that is the concept of detection and ranging. So radar means radio detection and ranging, the full form. Okay, now radar is an electromagnetic system, see, for the detection and location of objects. Now it uses by transmitting a waveform, usually a pulse modulated sine wave. Now that wave detects radar, it comprises of a transmitter. There you will have an antenna. So from that antenna, pulse modulated sine wave will be sent. Those waves will hit the target object, and that object will, when the wave strikes the object, that wave will get reflected, and that reflected wave is called echo signal. That wave, reflected wave, will travel from the target to the receiver, and that reflected echo signal will be received by the antenna at the receiving station, which is then processed to get information about the distant object, that is where it is located, at how much distance it is away from us, like that. Okay, now the value of radar lies not in being a substitute for the eye, but in doing what the eye cannot do. That is, radar cannot resolve details as well as the eye, nor it is capable of recognizing the color of objects to the degree of sophistication of which the eye is capable. That is, radar, it cannot resolve even the minute details of the object, just like that our eye do. Okay, at the same time, it cannot recognize color of the object. However, radar can be designed to see through those conditions impervious to normal human vision, such as darkness, haze, fog, rain and snow. In addition, radar has the advantage of being able to measure the distance or range to the object, which I have already said. This is probably its most important attribute. That is, the difference between the vision made by radar and human eye. That is, compared to human eye, radar cannot resolve the minute details of the object, but our eye can. At the same time, radar cannot recognize the color of the object, but human eye can do that. Now, what makes a radar or the vision of radar different from the vision of human eye is that radar can detect even a very small object, even in worse conditions, like under the conditions of weather conditions like darkness, haze, fog, rain, snow and all. Even in such worse weather conditions, radar can detect objects, but human eye cannot do that. It can do only up to a minimum extent. But radar can very easily detect those objects under such worse weather conditions. At the same time, radar can measure the distance or the range of the object, but human eye cannot do that. Okay. Now, radar consists of a transmitting antenna emitting electromagnetic radiations generated by the oscillator of some sort, then a receiving antenna, and finally an energy detecting device or receiver. A portion of transmitted signal is intercepted by a reflecting object target and is re-radiated in all directions. It is the energy re-radiated in the back direction that is of prime importance to the radar. Receiving antenna conducts the returned energy and delivers it to the receiver, where it is processed to detect the presence of the target and to extract its location and relative velocity. This is the main basic principle behind the working of radar, which I have already mentioned. So this paragraph is very important, so you'll have to learn this. Okay, now the distance to the target is determined by measuring time taken for the radar signal to travel to the target and back. The direction or angular position of the target is determined from the direction of arrival of the reflected wavefront. So this paragraph tells you about what is radar. Okay, then what makes radar different from human eye? Then this is a principle of working of radar and its main components. Now, the usual method of measuring the direction of arrival is with narrow antenna beams. If the relative motion exists between target and radar, that is, whenever there is a relative motion between target and radar, there will be a shift in the carrier frequency of the reflected wave, that is called Doppler effect, and that shift in the frequency of the reflected wave is a measure of the target's relative velocity. Okay, and if you get an idea about the target's relative velocity, it will help you to distinguish moving target or that particular target from stationary objects. Now, name radar reflects the emphasis placed by early experiments on a device to detect the presence of a target and measure its range. Okay, so it's a device used to detect the presence of a target and also to measure its range. So radar, it is a contraction of the words detection and ranging. Okay, radio detection and ranging. It was first developed to warn of the approach of hostile aircraft, that is to detect enemy aircraft, and also for directing anti-aircraft weapons. Then the measurement of range is still one of the radar's most important functions. And there is no, till now there is no other instrument discovered which can measure range as accurate as how radar does. So we have already said the wave that is used is the waves transmitted from the transmitting antenna is actually a train of narrow rectangular shaped pulses modulating a sine wave carrier. Now the distance or range to the target is determined by measuring the time taken TR by the pulse to travel to the target and return. So TR represents time taken for the waveform or the pulse to travel to the target and back. Okay, and so the range capital R is found out by using the formula C TR by 2. What is C? Velocity of light, 3 into 10 raised to the meter per second, and TR is the time taken by the pulse to travel to the target and back. Now here you can see a factor of 2 in the denominator because we have talked about two-way propagation of radar. Okay, the waveform traveling from the transmitter to the target and then back from the target to the receiver. Now, in order to express this range in kilometers or nautical miles, and if TR is represented in microseconds, then the above equation will become the range in kilometers will be 0.15 TR microseconds, and if the range is expressed in nautical miles, it will be 0.081 TR microseconds. Now, once the transmitted impulse is emitted by the radar, a sufficient length of time must elapse to allow any echo signal to return and be detected before the next pulse may be transmitted. Okay, therefore, the rate at which the pulse may be transmitted is determined by the longest range at which targets are expected. If the pulse repetition frequency is too high, then the echo signal from some target might arrive after the transmission of the next pulse. Okay, only after the transmission of the next pulse only the echo signal, that is the reflected signal, will arrive. And that condition occurs only if the pulse repetition frequency is too high and ambiguities in measurement range might result. So this will cause some uncertainty in the measurement of range. Now, echoes that arrive after the transmission of the next pulse are called second time around or multiple time around echoes. Such an echo will appear to be at much shorter range than the actual and could be misleading if it were not known to be a second time around echo. Okay, hope you understood the concept. Sometimes the echo signal will arrive only after the next transmitting pulse is sent. So in that will cause some uncertainty in the measurement value of range. So we must have an idea that that particular pulse is not the actual reflected echo signal, but the time around or multiple time around signal. Now, the range beyond which target appears as second time around echoes is called maximum unambiguous range and is given by C by 2 FP. FP is a pulse repetition frequency expressed in hertz. So, here you will get two definitions. What is second time around echo and what is maximum unambiguous range? This is a plot of maximum unambiguous range as a function of pulse repetition frequency. Now, although a radar transmits a single pulse modulated waveform, there are a number of other modulations. That is, a number of other modulations are also used. The pulse carrier might be frequency or phase modulated to permit the echo signal to be compressed in time after reception. That is, not only pulse modulation is applied, but we can use frequency modulation or phase modulation also. Now, this will give benefit of high range resolution without the need to resort to a short pulse. The technique of using a long modulated pulse to obtain the resolution of a short pulse but with energy of a long pulse is known as pulse compression. So that is the definition. What is define pulse compression? Okay. Now, continuous waveforms, that is CW, can also be used by taking advantage of Doppler frequency shift to separate the received echo from transmitted signal and the echoes from stationary cluster. Then, unmodulated CW waveforms do not measure range, but a range measurement can be made by applying either frequency or phase modulation. So, these are just the basic fundamentals of what is meant by radar. Then, what makes the vision of radar different from the vision of human eye? What all things radar have? How it operates? Then, some what is define range? Then, define pulse compression. Then, what is meant by second time around? What is meant by maximum unambiguous range, etc.? All these expressions. Okay, so these are just a few concepts about basic concepts related to radar. In the next class, we will learn about the working principle, the block diagram of radar, what all components it have, and what is the function of each of those components, applications of radar, what are the various types of radar, etc. Okay, so for today, this is enough. Thank you.